Tom Kiss, the Inland Insider, and tonight we are coming to you from Chino Hills High School, where the Corona Centennial Huskies are taking on the Chino Hills Huskies. Corona Centennial is the number 5 team in the nation. They're number 1 ranked in this division, the Inland Division. Chino Hills comes in as the 4 ranked team. They're 10-2. The one thing you got to look for in this matchup tonight is Michael Eubank. He's the big quarterback for Corona Centennial. He engineers most of their drives. The other guy to look for is Barrington Collins. On the other side of the ball, Chino Hills has some playmakers in Ekpre-olomu, Nate Harris, Steve Smith, Brad Bergen, and Austin Johnson on defense. The only way Chino Hills is going to keep this game close is playing tough defense and controlling the ball. We're getting ready to start the game. There's a lot of atmosphere out here, live from Chino Hills.
Safety and good sportsmanship. Okay? That's the type of game that we want to see, and that's why we are here. Okay, you've earned your way here. We expect you to play good clean football.
Divine heaven tonight. Oh, open my sight. Yes, we're bumping on home tonight. I see hearts breaking. I feel tears falling. Oh yeah, seeds from a million years. I want love is talking. Seeds that fear subsiding, sliding down across a million years. But when I get home, I walk right up your street. Investigate all the sweet. Switch on your light.
So Corona Centennial wins this semifinal game tonight. Let's talk to Corona Centennial's coach, Matt Logan.
You guys have played this year?
They did a good job tonight. They played really tough.
A lot of times in the first half, they started to stop you in the beginning of the game. You started to slow. You didn't score in the first quarter. What were they doing? They were throwing you guys off.
First series, you know, we had that big fumble, but that's a big game. So disappointing because we did exactly the same thing we scored. So kind of frustrating. And then, we only had the ball like 3 times. They did a good job on offense, limiting our touches, and they did a good job playing defense.
Leading his team into the semifinals tonight was quarterback Michael Eubank. Let's talk to him.
The challenges in the first quarter and in the first half.
The main challenges we had is just how they stuffed our run. The run game, you know, being a spread offense, we definitely like to run the ball. And being that they stopped us a little bit on the run, that kind of set us back a little bit. So we had to go ahead and, you know, redo our game plan, and it came out in perfection.
How much confidence did it give you guys going into the second half, knowing you scored those 2 touchdowns in 58 seconds, which basically was the difference of the game at that point?
Definitely after my last touchdown throw, it just sparked the whole entire sideline, sparked our team. We knew we was in it. We knew we weren't going home without a championship. And I told my team I wouldn't stop until we win this game.
Is that what you did?
I did. I definitely did. I told these guys, first of all, I did apologize for my lack of play. I played better every week, and this week it just didn't come out as good as I wanted to, so I had to apologize to my team. I told them I'll definitely make it up to them, and that we're not done yet. We're going to go keep going.
But this has been tough for you guys, because this is the first game you guys had to play 4 quarters. I mean, you sat out a lot of games. I've watched a lot of interviews. You have your hats off, but this is one of those challenges that you guys, do you feel you guys need these challenges to get to the championship?
It definitely helps. It definitely helps having these challenges, knowing what a full game feels like, knowing how to pull through the changes when we need to when it's fourth quarter, knowing that, you know, all the speed training, all the weightlifting we've been doing, it counts right here in the fourth quarter. And I'm glad that we had this fourth quarter victory. You know, I'm glad we were in this fourth quarter so that we can pull it together and we can show people that we're able to win, even if we're in the fourth quarter and that we just don't develop.
One of the offensive leaders for Corona Centennial night was running back Barrington Collins. Let's hear what he has to say.
Basically, this team, they hats off to them because they really did give us a challenge. I mean, this was a nail biter. Actually, I mean, third quarter, going into third quarter when they scored, when we threw the interception, they turned it back. I was like, okay, this is about to be one. We have to go all four quarters. And so basically, I just hats off to them. They are a great team, and basically, that's having two great teams meet. You got a shootout.
For Chino Hills and their final game of the season. Let's get Derek Bubb's thoughts on it.
What are your feelings right here after this game?
You know what? These kids showed their hearts. I mean, they came to play. I knew we'd come to play. Nobody gave us a chance. You know, first half, we felt like we played a great first half of football. Gave up some short scores. We had to go onside. We didn't feel like we could do it. We knew we were outmatched. We wanted to go onside all game. Even with the onside, we gave them two short fields late in the first half that killed us. And then you know, late in the game, penalties, offensive penalties for us.
You know, you look at that and you think back, you know, those last 58 seconds. You know, I seen it happen against Bishop-Mont, against Alameda, the same type of thing. What does that do to you guys going into halftime?
You know what? To be honest with you, it was our defense. It was our guys in the box, our linebackers, our defensive line. They let the guy. I can't ask our DBs to cover for 28 seconds or whatever it was. Kid was running around forever. And give all the credit to the quarterback. The quarterback, to be honest with you, is better than I thought he was. And, you know, he scrambled real well and he threw the ball real well. And
you heard anything that he did.
No, absolutely not. You know, our kids play their butts off. And you know, defensively, I just talked to one of the coaches. Coach said, you stuffed us all night long. That was closest that he felt like they were going to lose. So we felt like we played, you know, nobody gave us a chance. You saw it. You tried. I appreciate it. But nobody gave us a chance. You know, I think this score is a respectable score. And obviously, we wanted to win the football game. We felt like we could win the football game. But we need to play a perfect game. We didn't do that. Kudos to Centennial.
The stars for Chino Hills. They had a rough night tonight, but he did play well. Let's talk to Ekpre-olomu.
Shut them down basically back and forth, even in the second quarter. And then what goes through your mind when you guys take that lead and there's like a minute left?
There's a minute left. We're thinking, what I've learned, my coaches have taught me in my whole life, you don't play to just keep the lead. You have to play to blow them out. And that last 2 minutes, I think we were trying to keep the lead, and we were right back in the game because we were up 10-7 at that point. That's when we could play with them. They're no different than any other team. And when we got the interception, it just made bring us back down. And then I just don't – it just got a couple of plays that they had a third down, long third down. They got the conversion. I think that just kind of –
He's been an outstanding nose guard for Chino Hills this season. Let's get Austin Johnson's thoughts on the game.
You know, we got the intensity up, and then get intensity, got a sack, and then all of a sudden just break down, give up little plays, accept the plays. I'm just saying they're opposite basic. We optionally pass, and they knew it was coming, second and 20. We know the pass is coming, and just breakdowns, and keeping me tired.
So the final score for tonight's game is 42-23. Corona Centennial advances to the championship game next week. They will play the winner of Vista Murrieta or Rancho Cucamonga in the other semifinal that will be played tomorrow. The winner will meet Corona Centennial. Chino Hills ends their season 10-3. They go down. It was a close game until the end of the first half when two touchdowns in 58 seconds did Chino Hills in. They couldn't recuperate even though they got an interception for a touchdown to start the third quarter. But two fourth quarter drives by Corona Centennial sealed the win for them. So it's a wrap up. So for Dylan Kiss, who's been doing our video most of the season, thanks to Fred Robledo, thanks to the staff at the Tribune, we end this football season. We also would like to thank all the football coaches, all the players, and everybody else who helped out with the production of these interviews and highlight packages this season. For the final football game this season, this is Tom Kiss, reporting from Chino Hills High School for the Tribune.
Something, how to forget how to be true. myself in numb things. Don't touch me and I won't touch you. Trying to remember something.